entertainment for everyone, everywhere, every time.
It was four African head of states. After the statement of the president, that was a illegal statement, and I also make another statement and that he doesn't have authority to annul elections. This brings a concern to the whole of the world and Africa in particular. ECOWAS feel that they should come to Gambia and talk to both parties. It was a fact-finding mission. After talking to all of us, I think we will hear something from them on Saturday, because ECOWAS is meeting on Saturday. But the mission was a fact-finding mission.
We are meant to understand that the outgoing president is calling for power sharing. Is this true? And if it's true, is your government interested to share power with the outgoing president?
Not to my knowledge, and we are not interested in power sharing. I'm president-elect, and nothing can change that.
Why are you still not meeting the outgoing president? On national TV, he said his doors are open for you to meet him for deliberations and talk how to hand over power peacefully. But still now, we don't see you going to State House. Is there any problem?
That was the first instant. He congratulated me. Door of communication was open. There was Lezo Officer Balagaba Jahumpa. But after the second statement, everything gets stuck and there is some sort of a standoff. The communication is not there at the moment. We are still working on it. We believe that in a short period we will start communicating again. The ball will start rolling again.
The outgoing president was working with a lot of people, ministers, National Assembly, CDS, IGS. Will you be interested to absorb some of these people when it comes to office?
Well, for politicians, I think we have enough in that capacity. But civil servants, they always continue. The security forces, they are always there for every government for them to serve. I think for politicians, I don't think we are much interested. But anything can happen. Along the way, maybe you need somebody else's services among them. It's possible, but for now, I think we have enough to man those positions.
President, are you ready for these challenges? It seems Gambia is going through some tribal difficulties, commanding the Jola, the Sarafis. You are coming to be the president of the whole Gambia and you are preaching for oneness. Are you ready for the challenges when it comes to tribalism in the Gambia?
I am ready for the challenges, but I think people are also exaggerating. It is not up to that level. I think at a very, very minimal level. And my own composition, I think will help in that aspect, because I belong to three tribes, Mandinka, Fula, and Sarahule. I've always said it, my last two sisters are married to Jolas. I have my nephews who are Jolas from Fonyi. So my composition, I think, is a key in that line.
The Gambians are a bit confused and afraid. Soldiers are stationed all over, police, militaries are stationed all over. Did you hear from the CDS? Do you still get the backing of the IDP and the CDS when it comes to security for your incoming government?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, I think the CDS called me to congratulate me. And in his own words, we supported Yaya Jammeh 100%, but we will support you 250%. If there is no other statement, we'll always bank on that we have their support. And we have confidence in the security forces. I think we have a very good package for them. It will be a different thing completely. We will bring professionalism in all aspects, and we review their salaries. I think that is key here, and that is one of our priorities.
What about the civil service in general?
It's overhauled. We have to look at everything. Inflation have affected Gambia seriously. We have to look at salaries in line of inflation. And that is something that we have to look at and make sure we do something about it.
What's the relationship between your new government and Senegal? We see that the Senegal's media is giving you a lot of priority. Is this also going beyond just the media to the president, to the defense minister? What's the relationship in general between your government and Senegal?
The Senegalese president was the first to call me and congratulate me. And I think Senegal and Gambia, the relationship should be very, very, very strong. One, we are neighbors, close neighbors. Two, Senegal surrounds Gambia. And if Senegal is in peace, Gambia will be in peace. If Gambia is in peace, Senegal will be in peace. And I think Senegal and Gambia are the same people. We speak the same language. There is no language barrier between Senegal and Gambia. So that is very, 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 very important. That means we are the same people. I think Senegal and Gambia, that should be taken very seriously, so that our relationship will be very strong. I think that's why they are advocating for that all over Senegal, whether the government, civilian, businessmen, everybody is looking at that direction. I think that is very, very positive.
It was also said that you received security from Senegal. Is that true?
This is a private security, it's a private farm. I was not given official security. I could have been attacked by anybody. I was exposed to anything could have happened. Out of desperation, I have to look for alternative. It is not Senegalese government. It's private.
When are you naming your cabinet? Already some people have said that you said Honorable Ali Fasala is your vice president.
No, I don't know who are just giving those false news. And I think yesterday, Foria, said that was not from my camp. Maybe it's anybody who is trying to sabotage my government or whatever, but that is not what is going on. We are working on that. Very soon, we will have something in place. But as of now, nothing is ready yet.
You met the Christian community yesterday. What was the discussion?
Christian community, we are here to congratulate me on my victory, and they give me support as president-elect, and we are happy to receive them. They are part of this country. They did a lot for this country in a lot of areas. So that was their mission, and we are very, very, very happy, excited for them to come.
GDC is saying that he's not going to the polls. Is this mean that Gambians are not going for elections anymore?
No, Gambians are not going for elections. Gambians are not going for elections. Gambians have given their verdict, and that is the verdict of the God. Verdict of God. That's what the president said, and that's what we believe in. We are not going for the polls. It's over for Yaya Jammeh. I am the next president.
Advice for the coalition supporters and sympathizers, as many people are confused
right now. Advice is, let them keep calm. The international committee is behind us. That put us in a very, very, very strong position. I think it's APRC who are on the defensive at the moment. And I think they are losing every ground. We are very strong locally. We are very strong internationally. We have nothing to fear. But let's take it calm. And our approach is every Gambian. We are the same.
Thank you.
We have to maintain that peace. That is what we are advocating for.
Thank you so much for your time, Mr. President.
Thank you.